There's a guy who has gone to trial twice for something that's not even a crime in my estimation, and I guarantee yours. Let me first bring you back to the video and I will provide the update. Here it is. Okay. This is Orange, Texas. A man has his freedom hanging in the balance because he started a protest on the 4th of July. That's his protest. He's carrying a flag back of his vehicle. In the video, a man stops in front of Terrance Watson's black Saturn. He tried to remove Watson's flag that he dragged on the back of the vehicle. All right. And Watson told him, don't touch my flag. This is a peaceful protest. Don't touch my flag. Don't touch my property. Okay. Very simple. Then hit him once when he tried to take it. He told the man, don't take my stuff. Don't touch my stuff. Guy continues to touch his property, utilizes what we call appropriate force to stop the taking of property. You can do that, right? Legal. You can protect your property. You have the right to do so. He gets charged with a crime for doing this. He goes to trial, hung jury. They put him on trial again, hung jury. Let's put up the pictures full mass of this family man who was engaged in a peaceful protest, minding his own business, and now is being accused of criminality. This is Terrence's family photos. Mr. Watson is still charged at this moment with aggravated assault involving serious bodily injury following a hung jury mistrial after a second trial for the incident on July 4th, 2019 in Judge Courtney Arkeen's court in Orange County, Texas. All right, listen, I have not had any experiences with this judge, but I've had a lot of experiences with Karens, and my Karen vibes, the radar is going off right now. All right, the judge may be a Karen. Watson says prosecutors initially offered a plea deal with a 10-year sentence. Now, what do you think he's being prosecuted for? Do you think he's really being prosecuted because he punched a man in defense of his own property? No, he's being prosecuted for the protest. That's what he's being prosecuted for. They don't like his form of protest. What should happen here? We all clearly see what's going down, even in their hyper-conservative community. The jury members cannot say he acted outside of the scope of legality. Hung jury. The federal government should be watching this case, right? Or do you believe that the federal government should not get involved in such local issues? Maybe this is too small for the Biden administration. I wonder what would have happened if the presidency looked at Montgomery that way, or the Edmund Pettus Bridge, or local school systems who would not allow integration, but instead physically assaulted children at the local level. My point is, every movement like this has always been a local issue, and the federal government got involved. The federal government is able to get involved, is my point. There's more. In the 2 weeks since his verdict on the 9th, he still hasn't heard if he must face another trial. This would be number three. Watson described himself as proud of his African-American heritage. He says he wanted to protest on the holiday that celebrates that right. He said, I have no problem with anyone trying to protest, whether they be January Sixers or LGBT rights protesters. That is their constitutionally protected right. But you have to grant me my rights as well. The man who confronted Watson, Brandon Scott, admitted to following Watson a quarter mile when he saw Watson dragging the flag. That's called premeditation. He also refused an ambulance after he reported the incident to the police. That's called non-severe injury. Watson says he is skeptical he will get a fair trial, when many of the jurors come from Vidura, Texas, white community, conservative. This is part of a Sundown County Indisputable reported about white high schools, white high schoolers filming themselves chanting the N-word at that same school last year. Okay? It is steeped in racism, is the point. More details surrounding the incident, Mr. Watson told Indisputable. Brandon Scott said to him, "You stupid N-word, why are you dragging my flag?" See, if he would have been dragging a flag that said Black Lives Matter, this would not have been a problem. As a matter of fact, Mr. Watson may be receiving keys to the city, something like that. Scott claimed in court records he did not obstruct Watson's car or touch the flag when Watson punched him. Surveillance video completely contradicts that narrative, and we just showed it to you. Did Mr. Scott get charged with filing a false police report? No. Is Mr. Scott charged with lying under oath? No. Is it clear that Mr. Scott did not tell the truth about the incidents that occurred in the timeline he presented? Yes. Is it true that Mr. Watson is the person who has told the truth based on video evidence? Yes. At trial, Watson was permitted to cite Texas Penal Code subsection 9.41, which justifies the use of reasonable force against another person to defend property. He was not permitted to cite self-defense as a jury instruction. And Mr. Watson, let me say this to you, sir. They may very well try you again, okay? This is possible. They may try you again. By the judge giving an instruction to the jury to not allow an affirmative defense to be part of the matrix of your defense, opens up the opportunity for appeal if you are ever convicted of this ridiculous non-crime, okay? That appeal process must be reserved or preserved for the record. Simply, your attorney must object. Once the objection is properly affixed, it preserves it for appeal. Not an attorney in law school, just putting it into the universe. The judge may have done you a favor, all right? Watson told Indisputable he was denied a change of venue to have his case tried outside of the county, denied. Watson has spent a lot of money, thousands of dollars to defend himself. He is facing 25 years if convicted. Do you hear me? What you just saw on that video carries for Mr. Watson, based on how they charged him, a maximum of 25 years in prison. The man is literally fighting for his life and freedom for something that's not even a crime. It's constitutionally protected. We will continue to follow the story as Mr. Watson fights for his freedom or fights for his remaining freedom. All right, Sharon, thoughts here.
Number one, let me just say this quickly about the judge. I looked up the name Courtney. I think he said the judge's first name was Courtney.
I think so.
78%. It's a white name.
Yeah.
And she's, you know, I think I know what's going on down there, Dr. Richey. I'm just telling you, it was only 7% blacks.
Yeah.
He's up against it. And he will be probably tried a third time. And Colin Kaepernick is still not in the NFL. So you're right. This is really about something else. And no, he's not going to be allowed to. The law's not for him. The code is not for him. It's what they say, whenever they say, and how they say.
That's right. And once again, it's a dual justice system. One rule for whites, another rule for everybody else in that community. Keep in mind, this is connected at the same time as Jackson, Mississippi is about to receive a judicial system just to govern white residents of Jackson, Mississippi by way of the Mississippi state government signed off by the governor, already has passed one chamber of the legislative process.